to Lucid 9, where still doing this series after so freaking long. Oh god. Why? Where the next young? Well, yes, that was earlier, and I actually did that. Wait, it's midnight. Yeah, maybe. She leaps away, pointing at my clock in clean horror. Oh, looks like it is. Good God! I have to get going now. She horribly shoves the medication back into the cabinet and scrambles to the doorway. I instinctively grab her sleeve. Wait, what's the... Let's go now! She doesn't look like she's going so quickly. I quickly release her. Something draws on me. Dawns on me. Oh, Academy curfew. Wait, what? No, I have a permit because I'm of my father's job. Does this curfew even exist? Or does everyone just ignore it? That's what it is. Homework, sleep, schedule. Hi, Storm. How you doing, bruh? Good, he's still alive. No, nothing like that. Shouldn't it be obvious? A girl in a boy's home at a late hour. I don't mind it. wait, that's just that. It's nothing. Don't worry about it. I have plenty of girls over. Ryo was one of them. Heck, she even knows my key code to my door. Elizabeth doesn't seem to take this comforting. In fact, she turns white as a sheet. But plenty of girls? It's fine, people don't care around here. I care! What, you think I bang them all the time? Do you know that could... what this could do to my reputation? She pierces angrily, agitated, waving her hands. Her worry is stressing me. Look, like I said, it's not a big deal. Guys have girls over all the time. And the girls have guys over all the time. She stops in her tracks and stares at me. Oh, as friends? Yes! How many girls do you think I know? Well, what else would they be doing? You're asking because you don't know. I'm asking because I know. That is generally why people ask questions, yes. And according to you, girls come over, and guys come over, and they just study, or play games, or eat dinner, or whatnot. Well, yes! What else is there? That's exactly... Wait, what were you thinking? My god! I can't believe you were having... we're having this conversation. Oh god. This sounds like something I'd actually fucking... this would actually happen to me. Like, god damn it, man. Oh, fuck, bro. God damn it, man. She covers her face and rearranges her jacket quickly, opening the door. I just gotta go now. Hi, Sauce. How you doing, bruh? I'm left flabbergasted, and she slams the door in my face. I couldn't even get a word in. Well, that was abrupt. I swear I never knew what's going on in that head of hers. God, it probably doesn't mean anything to you, Yama. What is it? I'm not giving you money. But I believe you. Should I be scared? Before I can make a move, she promptly shuts the door again. This time I hear the rapid pinging, blinking of her shoes against the apartment hallway, and she strides out of the complex. She believes me. It believes in me. Of all people, Elizabeth Oshiro believes me. Now hopefully she doesn't die. Because I want Yaku to also make it too. Well, that's just like the irony of life, I suppose. And I can't deny that it's reasoning in the most bizarre way. Perfect. She's more confident than I am. In my innocence. It feels nice to have someone like that on your side. A fighter, a warrior, someone who knows you well, tell the truth to her face, even if you don't want them to. I can trust her, wordly enough. Well, that depends. I throw shit at people and it still works. Depends if I trust them or not. I boost it, the boost in my to my mood gets me into investigating mood, but I manage to steve it off. For now, I need to go to bed and get some rest. Wait, what sleep? I'm going to tackle this crime. I need to do it in an alert mind. And a lot of sleep. And you can't go to sleep, can you? I tossed awake by the rustle of a jackhammer outside my window. It's still dark out and my eyes are blurry. I rub at them. I squint to the street. A handful of men, garbage to bright orange, a handle around some crack in the middle of the road, surrounded by three large trucks. Definitely a construction work of some kind. But why this late at night? I fall back into my bed and jam my pillow into my ears. But it's futile. The noise pounds straight through my wall. No matter what I turn, why I turn, it continues to throb. It throttles me from all sides. Hopefully it's not Elizabeth! Aggravated, I leap out of my bed and head to my living room, kneeling at the television, between my temples. Of all times to choose construction, did it really have to be at such an ungodly hour? Well, knowing to my knowledge they normally do it during the day, as overtime is kicked in. I retreat to my living room and lie on the sofa. But sleep avoids me. Looks like it's gone for good. Well, clearly this isn't going to work. I decide to just get up and start the day. What time is it? Let's see, breakfast? fridge. Completely empty, of course. Well, time to get food. To be fair, it's been a while since I've gone grocery shopping, but that does nothing to stop me my growing irritation. Today looks like it'll be fantastic. I heard the door to pull. Yeah, I heard the door to pull my shoes, but a sudden alert from my phone stops me in my tracks. Who could it be? I must know. God dang it! I have not heard from you since in some time, Mr. Troll. Is a night bothering you? Nights can often be unreasonable. God dang it. No, I don't need another mysterious email. I don't need advice. I don't need any of this. Well, he must be hearing in. Unreasonable. Wasn't there something about the case that's unreasonable? Like dealing with me? Come to think of it, maybe I should check into the independent killings again. Well, at least we have some sources. Wait, don't tell me I have to choose. Thank God. From the sounds of it, these killings might have substantial contact to these cases. To this case. Well, I guess the internet exists for a reason. I withdraw my phone, reading such an incompetent killings. Only a few options pop up, and when I tap on them, they never load, only springing in place. Well then, that'll make it entertaining for me then. What the heck? I tap again. Refresh. Restart my browser. Nothing. My internet's fine. I checked the NNN website. Well then. Hey, best cat places to go, bro. And it loads within a second, but nothing with the incompetence of killings. Seriously, the last thing I need is tech problems. Time to go to tech support! Today seems to be one of those days where nothing goes right. I struggle to stay, to keep still breathing. Deeply, to stave off some irritation. My interrupted sleep pattern, with a nagging twist of a hammer, is starting to haze my brain. Perfect! Not like sleep is needed anyways! Oh, I need to fight this. First, I have to buy groceries and make some breakfast. Feeling my stomach will help me think clearer. Well, I haven't eaten for a majority of the day. Most I had was like 4 really tiny muffins and some lasagna. Like, that's not a whole lot. And when I mean tiny muffins, you could have like 2 to 3, maybe even 4, fit pretty much sit in the palm of your hand. Yeah, 2 to 3, maybe 4, sit in the palm of your hand. Like, that's how tiny they are. Yes, that was all I've had today. And some milk. So yeah. I head to the kitchen for my book of coupons. Technically, I'm not short on money, but it never hurts to save. It's one of the few things I can do for my parents. But when I look through my drawer, I find a phone tucked away in my back crevice. Phone? What's a phone doing here? I
kind of like, oh. Curious, I pick up, turning it over in my hand. I didn't recognize it. It's the latest premium landscape model. Upscale. Even for my standard. Whoever owns this has to be a really rich kid.
Don't tell me it's Yakko.
I try to switch the phone on, but nothing happens. Not even an empty battery, encoder. Indicator. Odd. It's completely dead.
Now we know.
I pry the back panel open, only to find that there's nothing where the battery should be.
Well, you know we ain't gonna turn on now.
Weird. Looks like someone took out the battery. So now I have to get... Now I've got this random phone. And I have no idea where it comes from. Wait, isn't this the model that Mitsuki was talking about before?
What is it?
It says here they're holding some kind of lottery drawing for weed.
Yes, that's a drug.
What? Why would they be giving away that away at a dwelling? I'm puzzled as well.
Intrigue? Someone mind explaining what this weed is?
It's drugs. Weed is just an acronym for Will Electric Energy Director. It's a new landscape cell phone that can run on power from a wall socket, even without a battery.
Oh yeah, that's right. If this is the new model that Mitsuki was raving about, I can just use my universal landscape charger to turn it on. Hopefully?
Well, this point, I might as well just freaking save the episode.
So I'll see you guys next time, and I hope all of you have a great one of the time.
So, and a great day, too. So, I'll see you guys next time. Wait, wrong button. Oh, crap.